Hello dear students, welcome again. In this class we are going to discuss what is meant by an invertible matrix, what is inverse of a matrix, and the theorems associated with inverse of a matrix, and one of the procedure to find inverse of a matrix, that is by using elementary transformations. Now let us move on to discussing one by one. In order to say that a matrix is invertible matrix, remember invertible matrix, inverse of a matrix are associated with only square matrices, not with rectangular matrices. So if a square matrix A is said to be invertible, a square matrix A, say of order n, means n number of rows, n number of columns. To say that this square matrix is invertible, if and only if there exists one more square matrix of the same order, say n, such that what the condition it has to satisfy is A into B must be same as B into A. Each of these two product should end with identity matrix of order n, then matrix A is called as invertible matrix, otherwise not. I hope you followed. A square matrix A of order n is given, maybe of order 2 you can imagine. You should be able to find one more matrix B, or there must exist one more matrix B of the order 2 only, such that A into B should end with identity matrix of order 2. Even B into A should also end with identity matrix of order 2. Then the matrix A is said to be invertible matrix. If there does not exist any matrix B satisfying this condition, AB equal to BA equal to I, then we say that matrix A is not an invertible matrix. Now, the matrix B itself called inverse of matrix A and is denoted by A to the power of minus 1. To say that matrix A is invertible, there must exist one more square matrix B of the same order, such that satisfying this condition, then that matrix B itself is called inverse of A. This is in fact multiplicative inverse. After addition of matrices, we came to know what is additive inverse of A. I hope you remember. What is that additive inverse of A? When a matrix is added to A, you should end it what? Null matrix. Or that matrix is added to A, in both the cases you should get null matrix of the same order. What is that matrix? Minus A. So this minus A is additive inverse. Here it is called multiplicative inverse, because on multiplying what matrix with A, B with A, you are ending with identity matrix. So this is a multiplicative inverse. By default, when you say inverse of a matrix means it is understood it is a multiplicative inverse of the matrix. Now let me take an example. Say I take matrix A as 2 3 1 2. Now question is there any existing matrix B such that satisfying this condition, then I can say that this matrix A is invertible matrix, and that existed matrix B is called as inverse of the matrix A. Now let me write a matrix B. Consider A into B. Matrix A, first row 2, 3, second row 1, 2. Matrix B, first row 2 minus 3, minus 1, 2. On multiplying, first row, first column, 2 into 2, 4, plus 3 into minus 1, 4, minus 3, 1. First row, second column, 2 into minus 3, minus 6, plus 3 into 2, 6, minus 6 plus 6, 0. Then, second row, first column, 1 into 2, plus 2 into minus 1, 0. Second row, second column, 1 into minus 3, plus 2 into 2, 4, 4 minus 3, 1. This is identity matrix. Now consider B into E. First write matrix B, 2 minus 3 minus 1 2 into matrix A, that is 2 3 1 2. Multiply these two matrices now. First row, first column, 2 into 2 4, 4 minus 3 1. First row, second column, 2 into 3 6, minus 6 0. Now, second row, first column, minus 2 plus 2, 0. Second row, second column, minus 3 plus 4, that is 1. Since here, A into B is same as B into A is equal to I. I started with this matrix. I shown that there exists one more matrix B of the same order too, such that on multiplying A with B or B with A, you are ending with identity matrix of the same order, that is 2. Now, we can say that matrix A is invertible matrix. And what this B is? Inverse of A, that is a multiplicative inverse of A. Now, question is, how we are able to write this matrix? Can we do it by inspection method? No. There is a systematic procedure that itself is using elementary transformations. Later, we will come to know how to write the matrix B, how to find inverse of a matrix B. Before that, we'll discuss the theorems associated with the inverse of a matrix. First one, inverse of a matrix, if it exists, is unique. What is meant by this? Suppose if matrix A is invertible, means there exists one matrix B satisfying this condition, AB equal to BA equal to I. They are saying, if at all inverse of a matrix exists, it is unique. Means there will not be more than one matrix satisfying this condition. Means suppose if assume C is also one of the matrices that A into C equal to C into A equal to I. This is not possible because according to the statement it says if at all inverse of A exists means how many inverses are there? Only one inverse. It's not like B is also inverse of A, C is also inverse of A. And that is what this theorem says. Now let us prove this. In order to prove this, I will write if possible, B and C are inverses of A. According to the statement, it is not possible to obtain more than one inverse. But here I assume that B as well C are inverses of matrix A. That is what I assumed. According to the definition, if B is inverse of A, what is the condition it has to satisfy? AB equal to BA equal to I. Since C is also inverse of the same matrix, it has to satisfy the same condition. A into C must be same as C into A, must be equal to I. By definition, we written these two equations. If you are able to show that B and C are not different, they are one and the same, then proof is completed. They cannot be distinct, they are one and the same. So for that, let me start with matrix B. My job is to show that B matrix is same as C. I will write this B matrix as B into I. It is well known fact, when a matrix, square matrix is multiplied with identity matrix, that matrix is not going to alter. B is same as B into I. Now, I write this I as A into C. Because C is the inverse of A, on multiplying these two, the product is the identity matrix. I replace identity matrix with AC. So, this is written from equation 2. Now, we know that multiplication of matrices is associative. So, B into AC is same as BA times of C. using associative axiom. Now look at this BA matrix. What BA matrix gives us? I from equation 1. So I replace BA with I into C. This is written from equation 1. What I into C is? So you are going to get C only. So in this way we shown that matrix B is same as C. In the beginning we started with saying let B and C are two different matrices satisfying these two conditions, nothing but they are two different inverses of A, but we ended with B equal to C, therefore they cannot be different, they must be one and the same. In this way inverse of a matrix if at all exists means it is one and only one, it cannot be more than one. That is what the theorem says. Next one, if A and B are invertible matrices of the same order, then AB whole inverse is equal to the product of inverse of B and inverse of A. Now let us prove this. From the definition of inverse, what we know is A into A inverse is equal to I. You come back here, A into B equal to I. What B is called as inverse of A. It is denoted by A inverse. So replace B with A inverse. What you are going to get? A into A inverse is A inverse into A is equal to I. That is what I written. By definition of inverse, if A is invertible matrix, then multiply with its inverse, you are ending with identity. Here I treat AB as one single matrix, say C. Okay, C is a single matrix. I am multiplying that C matrix with its inverse. By definition of inverse, AB into inverse of AB gives us what? Identity matrix, same as here, A into A inverse is I. AB is treated as a single matrix, C and its inverse, when they multiplied, you are ending with identity matrix. That is what I written. Now, pre-multiplying both sides by A inverse. So A inverse times of AB into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse into I. I get matrix multiplication is associative. A inverse times of AB is same as A inverse A into B into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse into I. A inverse is also one of the square matrix. When that square matrix is multiplied with identity, it remains same. What A inverse into A? It is I. I into B into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse. Now what is I into B? It is B only. It is B into AB whole inverse is equal to inverse of A. Now again pre-multiplying both sides by B inverse. What is the guarantee that B inverse exists? In order to multiply, inverse of B must exist. In the statement of the theorem they are given, if A and B are invertible matrices, means inverse of A exists, inverse of B also exists. So with that guaranteed only, we are multiplying first both sides by A inverse. Now here multiplying both sides by B inverse. If B inverse does not exist, A inverse does not exist, no question of multiplying both sides by their inverses. So it is guaranteed inverse of A, inverse of B exist because of the statement of the theorem. Now I am multiplying both sides by inverse of B. So it is B inverse into B. Inverse of AB matrix is equal to B inverse into A inverse. What B inverse into B? I into inverse of AB equal to inverse of B into inverse of A. I times of this matrix remains same. That is AB whole inverse is B inverse times of A inverse. That completes the proof. Very simple. First theorem says inverse of a square matrix exists means it is unique. For a given matrix, there will not be more than one inverses. That is what the theorem. Just like in the case of real numbers, that will be convinced to you. What is the additive inverse of 2? That is, on adding what number to 2, you are going to get additive identity, that is 0. What number you have to add in order to get 0? Obviously, minus 2. So, minus 2 is additive inverse of 2. How many additive inverses are there for 2 means? Is there any real number other than minus 2 satisfying this condition? No other number. Therefore, additive inverse of 2 is unique. One and only one, namely it is minus 2. Similarly, for a square matrix A, if inverse exists means, how many inverses are there? Only one. That is what the uniqueness theorem of the uniqueness theorem. Another theorem says, AB whole inverse is B inverse, A inverse. So, using these basic properties, we are able to prove this. Now, let us move on to discussing about elementary transformations and the procedure to obtain inverse of a square matrix. Now, we'll discuss about elementary operations, or they're also called as transformations. There are 6 elementary operations that can be performed on matrix. Let me write one by one. First one, Ri, double headed arrow mark, followed by Rj, where capital R stands for row, suffix indicates the row number. What this double-headed arrow mark represents is interchanging. So, here one of the operation is, you can interchange ith row with jth row of a matrix. For example, I write the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. And I write the operation R1 double headed arrow mark R2, indicating I am performing a operation, elementary operation, where I am interchanging row 1 and row 2 elements. This is row 1, this is row 2. I am interchanging them. So, what is the resulting matrix by this? I have to write second row elements in first row, first row elements in second row. So, interchanging R1 with R2 is symbolically written like this. In general, interchanging ith row and jth row of a matrix. Similarly, with respect to column operation, I can write ith column interchanged with jth column. Column wise means, now 2, 4 is written in the first column, 1, 3 must be written in the second column. If at all you are writing the operation like C1 interchanged with C2, the earlier matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, if I write C1 interchange with C2, what is the resulting matrix? 2, 4 present in second column, write it in first column. 1, 3 present in first column, write it in second column. Equivalent column operation it is. Second one, Ri changes to k times of Ri. Ith row elements were altering. How are altering? By multiplying with non-zero real number. This is written symbolically like this. Ri changes to k times of Ri. Let me write one specific example here. R1 changes to say 2 times of R1. Nothing but now you are going to multiply all the elements of first row by 2. Second row we are not changing. We are altering only first row elements. How? By multiplying with 2. That is 2 into 1. 2, 2 into 2, 4. This is what the resulting matrix. You are allowed to multiply a row elements by fixed constant, non-zero constant. In general, ith row is changed to k times of ith row elements. You are multiplying ith row elements by k. This is what the symbolic representation. Equivalently here, in the column operation, what I can write? Ci changes to k times of ci. Here, in this case, if I write that column operation, so I write C2 changes to 3 times of C2. Means what? I am going to multiply second column elements by 3. This is second column element. I have to multiply all the elements of second column with 3. First column, no change. Second column, 2 is multiplied with 3, 6. 4 is multiplied with 3, that is 12. Next. Ith row changes to, I am changing the ith row elements. How? By multiplying jth row elements by k, add those product to corresponding elements of ith row. Ri changes to ith row elements plus k times of jth row elements. Let us see how I can do it. Now R1 changes to R1 plus, that is I am adding some elements to R1. What elements I am adding? 2 times of R2, that is I multiply second row elements by 2, the resulting elements are added to corresponding elements of R1. Let us see how I had to write the resulting matrix. Since I am changing R1, no changes to R2. Let me write R2 elements as it is. I am changing R1 elements. How I have to change? R1 element changes to R1 plus 2 times of R2. This is R1 element. Let me write R1 element plus 2 times of the corresponding element in R2. So this is the element. So I have to multiply with 2, 2 into 3. This element I had to change now. It is a 2 plus, that is R1 element plus 2 times of corresponding element in R2. It is 4. It is a 2 times of 4. This is equal to S 1 plus 6, 7, 2 plus 8, 10, second row as it is. So this is the resulting matrix obtained after performing this elementary operation. I change R1 elements. How? By adding 2 times of R2 elements to R1. In general, ith row elements are changed. How? First multiply jth row element by k, then adding it to ith row elements. So this is how we are changing. Equivalently, here I can write ith column elements changes to ci plus k times of cj. Jth column elements are multiplied by k, added to ith column. So let me take this matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. I am changing c1 elements. How? C1 plus, say, half of c2 I write. It means what? We are changing c1 elements, not c2 elements. Let me write C2 elements as it is. How I am changing first column elements? To the column 1 element, I had to add half of second column elements, so half of 2. For this element, 3 plus half of its corresponding element, 4. Now let me simplify this. What you are going to get? 1 plus 1, 2. 3 plus 2, 5. 2, 4. So I change column 1 element. How? Column 1 changes to column 1 plus half of column 2. So this is how we have to operate. So these are the basic 6 elementary operations or elementary transformations of a matrix. You can interchange any 2 rows. You can multiply with some non-zero constant to any row elements. or multiply say second row elements by some non-zero constant and adding it to first row element, or maybe you can add it to third row elements like this. Similarly, the column operations. Now with these elementary operations, how we can proceed to find inverse of a matrix? Before that, there is a property that you have to remember well. In higher classes you will came to know what is the restriction, but right now remember the rules. The rules are like this. Whenever there is a matrix equation, say x equal to a into b, I am applying sequence of row operations. There is an equation of the type matrix x equal to matrix a into matrix b. I am applying sequence of row operation. Maybe I am interchanging R1 with R2, or I am multiplying third row elements by some number 1 by 2, or third row elements is multiplied by 2, I am adding it to first row. Whatever it may be the row operation you do. Whenever you perform row operation on this kind of matrix equation, the procedure is you need to apply those row operations only on X and A, not on B. Is it clear? You should apply those row operations on X matrix, on A matrix. For example, so this is what the equation you have. I write R1 interchanged with R2. On which matrices I have to apply this? On the left hand side, only one matrix I have to apply. On the right hand side, two matrices are there. For the first matrix only I have to apply this. You should not apply to the second one. So what is the resulting equation you get? R2 changes to R1, interchange. First row elements 3, 4, second row element 1, 2 now. Here, 0, 1 in the first row, 1, minus 1 in the second row. Don't alter this. You write this first row 2, 3, second row 1, 2. So we applied only for these two matrices. That is what the property is. When you are using row operations on this kind of equation, you apply those sequence of row operations on X and A, not on the second matrix of the RHS. Apply only on X and A. Suppose if you are applying column operations, then you need to apply these column operations on X and the second matrix now. Follow this. So when there is a matrix equation of the kind X equal to AB and you are using a sequence of row operations, apply those sequence of row operations only on X and A, not on B. If you are applying a column operation, and then apply those column operations on X and B, but not on A. This is what the rule that you have to remember. Next, whenever we are using row operations, to find inverse of A, we have to start with the equation A equal to I into A. The procedure to find inverse of matrix A using elementary row operations, you start with the equation A equal to I into A. What is I into A? Will give us A only. Now, you have to apply sequence of row operations. You have to go on applying sequence of row operation, either of these three, till you get an equation of the kind I equal to. On applying row operations, on which matrices I have to apply? On A matrix, on I matrix, not on the second matrix of the RHS, the previous rule. So apply row operations on A, apply row operations on I. Definitely these two matrices will change, and do the modifications, do the row operations in such a way that this matrix A should end with what? Should end with what? Identity matrix, that is 1001, like that it should end. Obviously this identity matrix, no more identity because we change the elements. Let me name it as B. Since we are not applying any row operations on this matrix, it is not going to change, it remains same. So whenever required to find inverse of A using elementary row operations, you always start with the equation A equal to I into A. Apply sequence of row operations till you obtain equation of the kind I equal to B into A. This matrix B itself is acting as inverse of A, B equal to A inverse. So this is the procedure you have to remember. Suppose if you don't want to use row operations, I want to use column operations, then the procedure is you start with equation A equal to A into I. This is column operations, this is row operations. Again A into I is also A. Apply sequence of column operations. On which matrices I have to apply column operations? Left hand side matrix I have to apply, and here the second matrix on the RHS I have to apply. You should not apply on this matrix C. And apply sequence of column operation, definitely this matrix A changes. You do the changes in such a way that it should end with identity matrix. You are not applying anything here, you write this matrix A as it is. This I, no more identity matrix because elements are going to change. Say you write that modified matrix as B. Now this B itself is acting as inverse of A. This is the procedure you have to follow. I hope you understood. In order to find inverse of a square matrix using elementary row operations, always start with the equation A equal to I into A. Apply sequence of row operations, plan sequence of row operation in such a way that this matrix A should reduce to identity. This I is going to change, I written as B. We are not applying any row operations on this according to the rule, it remains same. This matrix B on the RHS itself is inverse of A. If you are using column operation, you start with the equation A equal to A into I and apply sequence of column operation such that this matrix A reduced to identity. This identity, no more identity because elements are going to change, it will become some other matrix, say marked as B. On applying column operation, matrix A is not disturbed, written as it is. So this B matrix in this equation is acting as inverse of that matrix. Remember, not all square matrices are invertible. There are some matrices whose inverse does not exist. They are not invertible matrices. Then how to identify the given matrix as inverse as or not? The procedure is, while applying the row operations, in between you will get on the left hand side matrix either first row or second row or third row elements, all will become zero on applying some row operations. If you are able to get this kind of matrix where all the elements of any one row will be zero, then stop doing that row operation. Conclude that since all the elements in particular row are all zero, inverse of a matrix does not exist. That is what you have to write. I hope you followed. What kind of matrix will not have inverse? considering this equation A equal to int A, doing some sequence of row operations in between on the left hand side matrix, you will arrive at the stage where all the elements in any one row will become zeros. Then stop it and say this matrix is not invertible, hence inverse of a matrix does not exist. Now let us take example to find inverse of a matrix using this elementary row operation. Let me take 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the given matrix. In order to find inverse of a matrix using elementary transformations, elementary row operations in particular, I have to start with A equal to I into A. Consider A equal to I into A. That is matrix 1, 2, 3, 4 is equal to matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. Don't write this matrix A again, you simply write A. The reason is you are not going to apply any sequence of row operation on this matrix. No meaning in writing a complete matrix in the each and every step. You avoid it just by copying this matrix as it is. Now I have to plan for sequence of row operations in such a way that this matrix should end with what? Identity matrix. Here this identity matrix element get changed. I have to write sequence of row operation in order to obtain this equation. Then I can write which is of the form I equal to B into A, because I have to obtain this equation which is of the form I equal to B into A. Therefore A inverse is B matrix. So this matrix I have to consider as inverse of that matrix. Let us see how I can do it. Remember, whenever you considered a 2 by 2 matrix, in order to make this identity, you first make a target, this element. You target this first element and try to reduce that element to 1. Then the second target is this. This element should become what? 0. I have to reduce this to 0. Then the target is this element. You make it 1. Then the next target is this. You make it 1. I mean 0. You have to follow this pattern. Target the first element, you make it 1 by doing some row operations. Second target is this element, you make it 0 again by using row operations. Then this element must be the target, make it 1. Then this element is the target, make it 0. Okay, you are going to follow that pattern. Then there will be no difficulty in between. Now observe this matrix. The first target is this element. I have to make it 1 because I have to get it identity. It is already 1. We are clear. Next target is this one. What this element should be? 0. How I can make it 0? Here 3 in the first row corresponding element 1. Somehow I have to make it 3 as 0. I am using this operation. Third one, I am changing R2 elements, because in the second row this element is targeted. I have to alter this element 3 to 0. Now look at here what I am writing. R2 plus minus 3 times of R1 I write. I choose on the k value as minus 3. It can be any number other than 0. So I choose on minus 3. What this operation means, you multiply first row elements by minus 3, add it to second row elements. Now, we are not changing the first row elements. You write as it is. We are changing the second row elements. How? First multiply first row elements by minus 3, add here. So on multiplying this 1 by minus 3, minus 3 into 1, minus 3, it should be added to 3. Minus 3 plus 3 is what? 0. Then for this element, which number I have to add? Minus 3 times of 2. What is the minus 3 times of 2? Minus 6. Minus 6 plus 4, it is minus 2. Now, in this matrix, to this 0, what element I have to add? Minus 3 times of 1. Minus 3 into 1 plus 0, it is a minus 3. To this element, I have to multiply this element by minus 3 and add here. Minus 3 into 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1. I hope you followed this. So, this element is over now. So, this is 1, this is 0. What is the target element now? This one. What I have to make it? 1. How I can make it 1? Minus 2 is there. I want to do it 1. I am using this operation now. You are allowed to multiply the row elements by any non-zero constant. By multiplying with what? This number becomes 1. Obviously minus 1 by 2. So I write R2 changes to minus 1 by 2 times of R2. I am multiplying second row elements by minus 1 by 2. Reason is, this element should reduce to 1. What is the resulting matrix? It is 1, 2, because the first row elements doesn't change. Second row elements I have to multiply by 2, minus 1 by 2. 0 into minus 1 by 2, 0. Minus 2 into minus 1 by 2, 1. Minus 3 into minus 1 by 2, plus 3 by 2. 1 into minus 1 by 2, it is minus 1 by 2. So, 3 elements are completed. Now, I have to make it 1. Don't multiply first row by 1 by 2. If you multiply by 1 by 2, what happens? First element will change to 1 by 2. Second element will become 1. Of course, we need the second element as 1. You try to see that this first element should not change because I have to end with this. So, in this case, in order to make this element 1, I am taking use of second row elements. Now, let me write the operation. I have to change R1 elements. R1 changes to R1 plus minus 2 times of R2. I am multiplying second row elements by minus 2, adding it to first row elements. Minus 2 into 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1. This one. 1 into minus 2, minus 2, minus 2 is added to 2, you are going to get 0. Second row elements as it is, you are not going to change them. So in this matrix also, let me write the second row elements. It is a 3 by 2, minus 1 by 2. Now R1 is changing. How we are changing? Multiply these second row elements by minus 2, adding it to first row elements. Minus 2 times of 3 by 2, minus 3. Minus 3 is added to 1. How much? Minus 2. Minus 1 by 2 times of minus 2, it is 1. 1 is added to 0, it is 1. Now look at this equation. It is of the form, I equal to B into A. Therefore, what is the inverse of matrix? B. So A inverse is B, it is minus 2, 1, 3 by 2, minus 1 by 2. This is what the inverse of the matrix is. You can confirm it, whether it is really inverse of a matrix or not. How I have to confirm? Multiply A with A inverse. Check whether you are going to get identity matrix or not. What is the matrix A? 1, 2, 3, 4. What is A inverse? Just now we determined. First row minus 2, 1. Second row 3 by 2, minus 1 by 2. that is equal to first row, first column. 1 into minus 2, minus 2. 2 into 3 by 2, 3. First row, second column. 1 into 1, plus 2 into minus 1 by 2, minus 1. Second row, first column. 3 into minus 2, minus 6, plus 4 into 2, 4 into 3 by 2, 6. Second row, second column. 3 into 1, 3. 4 into minus 1 by 2, minus 2. What you are going to get? 1, 0, 0, 1. Similarly, A inverse into A is also going to give us I. In this way, this matrix what we written is perfectly acting as multiplicative inverse of the matrix. You see, what is the procedure? To find inverse of a matrix using elementary row operations, you have to start with A equal to I into A. You plan sequence of row operation in such a way that this matrix reduced to identity matrix. Then this identity is going to change, become some other matrix, that is B. This B matrix itself is acting as identity matrix. That is what we did here. We started with A equal to I into A. We planned here in this example three row operations we completed. After completion of this sequence of row operation, I end with equation of the kind I equal to B into A. This left hand side matrix A reduced to identity, then this matrix itself is inverse of a matrix. I hope you followed this. The procedure same, but this sequence of row operations what you are applying, it keeps on changing based on what kind of elements are there in the matrix. These are not fixed operations. We can change according to your convenience. But the convenient procedure is make this element first target, reduce to 1. Then this element is the second target. You reduce that real number to 1. The third target is this element present in second row, second column. This element should reduce to 1. Then the final target is this element, you reduce to 0. If you go in this way, then there will be no difficulty at all. I hope you followed the procedure. Now you are able to answer the questions given in exercise now 3.4. There you will be observing both square matrix of order 2, square matrix of order 3 are there. We will be completing only square matrices of order 2 because order 3 is not in our state syllabus. Means, of course, there, but in the board exam, that question will not appear because it is a lengthy process. In CBSE syllabus, it may ask for 5 marks or for even 6 marks, 3 by 3 matrix, to find inverse of a 3 by 3 matrix using elementary row operations. So, suggestion is you just go through only square matrices of order 2. Take a break here. With this idea, you try to answer those questions, because next I am going to answer those questions. Exercise 3.4, question number 1. They are given matrix of order 2, 1, minus 1, 2, 3. Required to find inverse of a matrix using elementary transformations. So as usual, we have to start with the equation. Matrix A equal to I into A, that is matrix 1, minus 1, 2, 3, identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1, into matrix A. Now apply sequence of row operations till you end with identity matrix equal to B into A. That B matrix itself is inverse of matrix A. Now which is the first element to be targeted? This one. It is already 1. No need to worry. Second element, this one. I have to target this element. And to which number I have to reduce? 0. How I can make it 0? Look at here. This element is 2. This is 1. I multiply this 1 with 2. Subtract here. Nothing but the row operation is R2 changes to R2 plus minus 2 times of R1. or simply we can write R2 changes to R2 minus 2 times of R1, they are one and the same. Either of these two you can write. Now here we are changing second row elements, not first row elements. So let me write the first row elements as it is. It is 1 minus 1 on the RHS, 1, 0. Anyhow, we are not going to apply row operations on this second matrix of the RHS. I will simply copy that matrix A as it is. Second row elements on R2 changes to R2 plus minus 2 times of R1. Multiply this element by minus 2, add it to this. Minus 2 into 1, minus 2, minus 2 plus 2, 0. Again, multiply this element by minus 2, add it to 3. Minus 1 into minus 2 plus 2, 2 plus 3, it is 5. Here, multiply this element by minus 2, add it to 0. Minus 1, 1 into minus 2, minus 2 plus 0, minus 2. 0 into minus 2, 0, 0 plus 1, 1. Now, 1, 0 is completed. Now, the target element is this. I have to make it 1. Look at here, 5 is there. I have to make it 1. Very simple. R2 changes to 1 by 5 times of R2. I am multiplying second row elements by 1 by 5. Again, we are not changing the first row elements. We will write those first elements as it is. 1 minus 1 on the RHS, 1, 0. Multiply these second row elements by 1 by 5, 0 into 1 by 5, 0, 5 into 1 by 5, it is 1. Now, minus 2 into 1 by 5, minus 2 by 5, 1 into 1 by 5, it is 1 by 5. Now, these three elements are correct, 1, 0, 1. Now, I have to make this 0. Look at here, minus 1, here 1 is there. I write, R2 changes to, sorry. R1 changes to R1 plus R2. What is the resulting equation you get? Now in this case we are changing R1. So let me write R2 elements as it is. 0, 1. This is minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5. Simply adding second row elements to first row. 1 plus 0, 1, minus 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus minus 2 by 5, that is 1 minus 2 by 5, how much it is? 3 by 5, 0 plus 1 by 5, it is 1 by 5. So which is of the form? Matrix I equal to B into A, because this second left hand side matrix is reduced to identity. Here only you can stop, you write simply, which is of the form I equal to B into A. Therefore, A inverse equal to inverse of matrix A, this matrix B. It is 3 by 5, 1 by 5, second row elements, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5. I hope you followed this. Next, second one, again matrix of order 2 by 2 is there, whose elements 2, 1, 1, 1. As usual, I have to start with the equation A equal to I into A, that is matrix 2, 1, 1, 1 equal to I 1, 0, 0, 1 into matrix C. Now, first target element is this. I should make it 1. Very simple here. Look at this element 2. This is 1. If I subtract 1 in 2, it will become 1. So, idea is R1 changes to R1 plus minus 1 into R2. It is same as what? R1 changes to R1 minus R2. I multiply second row elements by minus 1, adding it to first row. So here we are not going to change the second row elements. Write the second row elements as it is first. We are changing the first row elements. R1 changes to R1 plus minus 1 times of R2. 2 plus minus 1 into 1. 2 minus 1, it is 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 0 minus 1, minus 1. Now, the next target element is this. I have to make it 0. It is quite simple. Here 1, in the first row 1, just subtract first row elements, you are going to get 0. That is, now I am changing R2 elements. R2 changes to R2 minus R1, I write. In this case, I am changing second row elements, not first row elements. So write first row elements as it is, 1, 0, 1, minus 1. I am changing second row elements how? By direct subtraction with first row elements. 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 0 minus 1, minus 1. 1 minus of minus 1, R2 minus R1. 1 minus of minus 1, 1 plus 1, it becomes 2. Now write which is of the form. Which is of the form I equal to B into A. Therefore, A inverse equal to this B matrix. It is 1, minus 1, minus 1, 2. That completes the example. Let me answer one or two questions. The other questions we should complete. Finally, I will solve question number 3, 4 and 12. Remaining questions you can try. You can skip square matrix of order 3 by 3 because they are quite lengthy. In CBSE pattern, those questions will be asked for 5 mark or even for 6 marks. But here in our state syllabus, they are restricted only to 2 by 2 matrix. Consider this matrix. As usual, I had to start with A equal to I into A, that is matrix 1, 3, 2, 7, is equal to identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1 into A. First target element is this, it is already 1, no need to worry. Next target is this element, I have to make it 0, here 2, here 1. Multiply first row elements by 2, subtract in second row, you are going to get 0. So therefore, I write R2 changes to R2 minus 2 times of R1. Here we are changing second row elements, not first row elements. So let me write first row elements without any change. How we are changing the second row elements? R2 minus 2 times of R1. Multiply first row elements by 2, then subtract in second row elements. It is 2 minus 1 into 2, 2 minus 2, 0. 7 minus 2 into 3, 7 minus 2 into 3, 7 minus 6, it is 1. 0 minus 2 into 1, 0 minus 2, it is a minus 2. 1 minus 2 into 0, it is 1. This element is already 0 now. Third target is this. With this operation only it becomes 1. We are lucky. Next, the last target is this. I have to make it 0. So here 3, here 1. What I can do? R1 changes to R1 minus 3 times of R2. I am multiplying third row elements by 3, subtracting in R1. As I am changing R1 elements, let me write first R2 elements as it is. We are not changing the R2 elements. 0, 1, minus 2, 1. How we are changing the first row elements? R1 minus 3 times of R2. 1 minus 3 into 0, it is 1. 3 minus 3 into 1, that is 3 minus 3, 0. 1 minus 3 into minus 2, that is 1 plus 6, that is 7. 0 minus 3 into 1, 0 minus 3, it is minus 3. Now clearly it is of the form which is of the form I equal to B into A. Therefore, A inverse is this B matrix. It is 7 minus 3, it is minus 2, 1. That completes the inverse. Now consider this example. So as usual, you start with matrix A equal to I into A. That is matrix 2, 3, 5, 7 is equal to identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1 into matrix A. So first target is this. I have to make it 1. How I can make it 1? Say here R1 changes to 1 by 2 times of R1. I get I'm changing R1, not R2, so write second row elements as it is. First row elements, multiply first row elements by 1 by 2. 2 into 1 by 2, 1. 3 into 1 by 2, 3 by 2. 1 into 1 by 2, 1 by 2. 0 into 1 by 2, 0. Next, this is the target element. I have to make it 0. How I can make it 0? R2 changes to R2 minus 5 times of R1. Multiply first row elements by 5, subtract here 5, here 1. Target is this, I have to make it 0. Don't worry about the other elements. As I am changing R2 elements, I will write first row elements as it is. What are first row elements? 1, 3 by 2, 1 by 2, 0. So now R2 changes to R2 minus 5 times of R1, 5 minus 1 into 5, 0. Next element, 7 minus 5 times of this element, it is 15 by 2. How much we get? Minus 1 by 2. Next, these elements, 0 minus 5 times of this, that is minus 5 by 2. 1 minus 5 times of 0, it is 1 only. Next target is this, I have to make it 1. This is minus 1 by 2, I have to make it 1. So I simply multiply second row elements by minus 2. I am changing second row elements. So let me write the first row elements as it is. In the first matrix, 1, 3 by 2, on the RHS first matrix, 1 by 2, 0. Now I am changing R2. How we are changing R2? Just by multiplying with minus 2. 0 into minus 2, 0. Minus 1 by 2 into minus 2, 1. Minus 5 by 2 into minus 2, it is 5. Minus 2 into 1, it is minus 2. Now I have to make this 3 by 2. Next target is this element. I have to make this 3 by 2 as 0. How I can make it 0? Look at here 1, here 3 by 2. Multiply second row elements by 3 by 2 and subtract in R1. That is, R1 changes to R1 minus 3 by 2 times of R2. That will give us the required matrix. Let me write here. Second row, 0, 1. In the second matrix on the RHS, it is a 5 minus 2 into A. Okay. Now let me write first row elements. R1 changes to R1 minus 3 by 2 times of R2. 1 minus 3 by 2 into 0, that is 1 only. 3 by 2 minus 1 into 3 by 2, that is 0. Now here, 1 by 2 minus 3 by 2 times of this element 5. How much it is? 1 by 2 minus 15 by 2, that is equal to minus 14 by 2, that is equal to minus 7. So this is minus 7. Next, this element 0 minus 3 by 2 times of minus 2. How much it is? 0 plus 3, that is equal to 3. Now write which is of the form. Which is of the form I equal to B into A. Therefore, A inverse is minus 7, 3, 5, minus 2. I hope you are following the examples. In different examples, different set of row operations we have to do based on the elements. Ultimately, this matrix A should reduce to identity matrix. That is how we had to plan. Now, finally, let me answer this twelfth question. As usual, I had to start with the equation A equal to I into A. Matrix A 6 minus 3. Minus 2, 1 is equal to I. It is 1, 0, 0, 1 into matrix A. Now, I have to make it 1. How I can make it 1? With the help of second row. Suppose if I write R1 changes to R1 plus 3 times of R2. What is the a resulting matrix? Let us check. Write second row elements as it is. Here I done row operation. R1 changes to R1 plus 3 times of R2. I am multiplying second row elements by 3, adding it to first row. To 6, what number I had to add? 3 times of minus 2, 6 minus 6, 0. For minus 3, I had to add 3 times of 1, minus 3 plus 1 into 3, it is 0. Now here, 1 plus 3 into 0, 1, 0 plus 1 into 3, 3. Observe the first row elements here. We said not all square matrices are invertible. How we came to know that some matrices will not have the inverse? While doing this kind of row operations on the left hand side matrix, if you are able to get all the elements as zeros in any row, that itself is the indication that the given square matrix has no inverse. So here we have to stop, no more row operations. Here only we can conclude, since all the elements in first row are 0, given matrix has no inverse, I hope you followed the examples. Remaining questions in this exercise may be 5 to 12, and after that also some 2 by 2 matrices are there. You try to complete this. So usually this question in the board exam for 3 mark. Find inverse of a matrix by elementary transformations. This is the procedure you have to remember. You have to start with matrix A equal to I into A. Apply sequence of row operations till you get the equation of the kind I equal to B into A. That matrix B itself is inverse of A. With this, this exercise is completed. In the next class, we will be discussing miscellaneous examples. I hope with the completion of the chapter, you can try those examples. In the next session, I am going to answer those. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.